Hi guys, I'm Digantude Shubha. This is the second part of the blur motion. Today I'll show you the animation tips on how I created this. You see, the car is moving as well as the camera with it. But the camera is moving fast. Okay, and the surrounding there is a blur. And there is a trick that I'll show you in this video. So as you can see, I have made the environment and this is our model. I have set the model and the camera view. Now you see I have splitted the four rings. So as you can see, I have already saved the camera and the angle. Now in my previous video, I have showed you how you can give blur to your model, and in here, in this video, I'm going to use it. So go to animation and animation wizard, choose the rotation. From your real-time view, choose the part, and now select finish. See, this part is moving. As this rim is moving backward, I want it to move on forward, so I'm going to give it a negative value and it will make the rim to go forward. You see, now let's increase the value at least 900 or above, so that the blur motion can be seen. Now I'm going to copy this to this part. Copy animation, and from here I'm going to just simply paste linked animation. Now both of my part got the blur motion. To make this car move like this, the car is moving, right? I'm going to use translation. Click on next and choose the set of the car. Click next, and here you see I want it on negative z axis. This is z positive and that will be z negative. So this will be 0 and this one, say how much, 20. Okay, finish. Now you see the car is moving, but because of the movement there is a blur on car. I can't see the car, especially the rim. Now to make it visible, I will need the camera to move along with the car. Go to animation wizard, select translation from camera animation. Click next, select your camera, click next, and from here give the same value as you did to the car. Now the camera is also moving with the car, and if you notice closely, the surrounding got the blur motion just like the animation from here. See, there is a blur, and here there is a blur, but I can easily see the car so as the rim. If you see it closely, then there is a slightly blur motion of the car, and the camera is moving fast here, not with the car. So to do so, I'm going to click on the camera and make this value a bit bigger than this, so the camera is moving before the car. Now you see there is a slightly blur motion to this car. If you increase it, then the blur motion will be increased. So now you get a basic idea on how to create the blur motion of your model. Let's off the camera mode and Now see. See? Like this. You can make the blur motion. I don't want it like this. I want it just like the same as the car. Yes, like this. You can give animation to your model. To render it, go to render and select animation. Choose your resolution and entire duration, video output, give it a name, system render none, and from here choose the formation. Go to option and make sure you select at least 15. The animation you see here was done with the maximum sample of 15. And if you choose higher, then it will be nice. And this animation was almost 4 seconds, and it took almost 5 hours to render because of my low configuration of this computer. And if your computer is high enough, then it will not take up to 1 hour or 2 hours. Choose the maximum sample and then click on the render. It will start rendering and you'll have to wait. For now, I don't need it, but let me show you just one sample on how it will look. You see, now there is a blur it's giving, and the ground or the surrounding is getting a blur motion, just like the real movie does. See? Now the rim got enough blur motion. If you increase the value from 900 to say 1000, more than 1000, then it will be much more. Say it's 15, like this. And this is the 15 motion I had. So it's okay to me. I don't want it, so I'm going to close it. So guys, if you think this animation tip was enough helpful for you or a bit helpful for you, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel and share with your friends. In the comment section, don't forget to give me the feedback. Your one feedback give me inspired to do more tutorial or like this. So for now, thanks for watching guys. Happy animation.